Hey, it's Sid with Table Talk with Sid, a life memo. I've been away in this area for quite a while, and a new subject came up, so I thought I would share it with you. I think it's something that touches a lot of people's lives. I started dating a guy, and he was telling me the other night about how he so badly has this passion to own a certain company, and he loves it. He kind of thrives on it. It's really, when he talks about it, you just see his shoulders go back, his chest come up, his eyes light up. He loves every single thing about owning this type of company. And I asked him why he had never owned it. And he said, you know, his mother has certain religious beliefs, and he would not want to do it because he's so concerned of hurting her. And I thought that this is something that I think a lot of people do in life. So, you know, everybody has the right to believe what they believe and to have their religions or no religion, whatever that is. And everybody has a right to have a certain outlook on life, whatever that is. However, as our own individual, it is not our responsibility to maintain somebody else's outlook on religion or life, to live according to their rules of their religion. It is not our responsibility to make sure that they are comfortable with us, with our choices, with our passions, with the kind of life we want to live. That's not where our responsibility lies. Our responsibility lies in the things that we do choose to do. Do we have gratitude? Are we serving our community in some way? Are we looking past ourselves? Are we doing things that bring our life passion and inspiration? Are we really focused on bettering ourselves, becoming more balanced, learning from our hiccups? Are we focused on recreating, reinventing ourselves to be a better person than just to continue to do the things that we've always done, no matter the downfall? Those are our responsibilities. Our responsibility to ourselves, to the community, to our families, is to be the person, the very best person we possibly can be. How we are the best person that we possibly can be is to fill our life up with gratitude, with the passions that we love, to go after the things that we want to do, to really strive to achieve goals that are important to our life, to see value in ourselves, in our opinions, in our talents, to see value simply in our ideas and who we are. That is our responsibility. And when we show responsibility to that, you will find that those around you now have been given their own responsibility. You're no longer taking that on. It is not your responsibility to make sure that they are happy with you. Everybody else is responsible for their own stuff. That's what they're responsible for. You are responsible for your stuff. It's quite interesting because even myself, I found myself living a life based upon, for many, many years, and my sister and mom are very deep into a certain religion. And I found myself all the way through adulthood where I was living my life based upon what might make them angry, so I'm not going to do that, or might make them question my character, so I'm not going to do that, or might make them question how hard I work or how dedicated I am, not going to do that. So I did find that you may be pleasing, I may be pleasing all those people around me by making sure that I'm living a lifestyle that meets their religious beliefs, but in the end, I was not fulfilled. I was not blooming and thriving. And really, really, the question is, how do you know when you're living the very best life for you? It is based upon how you feel. When you make choices, do you immediately feel inspired? if you do, head that direction. When you make decisions, do you feel hopeful? Do you have gratitude in your heart? If you do, you're going the right direction. If when you're doing things, you feel that uplift, the shoulders go back, the chest comes up, you feel hopeful, you get excited about life, you see more opportunity to help those who cannot help themselves, you see more opportunity to make a difference in the community, then you keep heading that direction. If those around you do not like what you are doing, those issues are not your issues. You must, as I told my friend, one of the most brilliant ways to approach is to thank his mother. Go thank her for raising him to be a man who can make good decisions, who make balanced decisions, a man who has great character, and a man who has gratitude and is caring. And because she raised such an amazing guy that is an asset to society, that he is amazing in or out of her religion, that she, and he does, need to say this, I'm grateful, mother, that you have the ability to have faith in me, to trust me, to stick with me, in me making choices for my life, because you raised me to do this, and I'm extremely grateful. These are things to just toss around, because in order to find happiness and peace and inspiration and passion and fulfillment, living life on other people's terms will never get you there. In your day, you may fall down, stand up, brush off, and move on. Talk to you.